What's up, friends? Today we're here to check out the new Chainsaw Man opening. Chainsaw Man is probably the most anticipated anime of this season, and possibly one of the more anticipated animes of all time because of its unique storytelling techniques and its ridiculousness. Because of that, the music from this opening can have a huge impact on the culture. We'll be looking at this music from the perspective of a producer and songwriter, so expect several pauses to go over specific sections of the song and talk about the development and the different instrumentation used. Straight off the bat, we're starting with a bass riff. It's a really dirty bass riff. You can hear a lot of the string movement going on there. It's definitely on the higher end of the bass, really catchy, driving the song. I like the keyboard interjecting there at the very beginning, as well as the chainsaw noise to start the song. I think Foley in songs is always a brilliant idea. I did a similar thing on my latest album where I'm talking about cutting wrists and I have a sound of a knife. So I think it can really add to the storytelling aspect of a song. You've got interesting places for the keyboards to come in, as well as the electric guitar that then led into the drums. That transition's really nice. You're adding that extra layer of savagery by adding the electric guitar, and then you're having the drums come in, which really increases the energy. Also, I like that they're having the keyboards and guitars come in on the offbeat. They're not coming in on the one or the two. They're coming on like those ands, real syncopated. I really like that sound, the doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doom. It's a really nice tone that they're getting out of the electric guitar, and just has this really nice build, you know, going down to up to introduce the primary vocal. Really digging the lead vocalist here. I love how scratchy his vocal is sounding. You can tell he's using a nice mixture of vocal fry and vocal breaking to create a really raspy and desperate sound. It also sounds like they're using a little bit of distortion on his vocal to even more so up that savagery, make his voice blend in with those electric guitars in a nice way. Quick pause. Please subscribe. Pretty please. Really like that back and forth you're hearing from the electric guitar and the vocal. Just great back and forth that we're getting there. Really close attention being played to the instrumentation, how it can interact with the vocal. Definitely a band is being considered here, you know. Every single instrument is being considered and how it plays off of each other. Changes up a lot of the melodic quality we're getting from this more minor sound to a more major sound. And you have the beat slowing down and locking in with the electric guitars to create this kind of wall of sound. Love that high end of the guitar. Just really going off there. Also, I like the melody here. It's doing kind of a major seventh in the melody, which adds this really interesting vibe to the song. You've got this savagery of a full band, this really rocking sound, these really raspy vocals, and yet they're doing a melody that's in a major seventh, which is non-traditional for that format. Really bringing in that city pop Japanese background, that jazzy background, into a rock song in an interesting way. Really like that vamping there. Just like repeating the melody, but having this slight variation at the end that introduces the transition into a new section. Nice, ending out with that electric guitar. Really distorted, really crunchy sounding. And then going into it, having probably the catchiest part of the song, which is that bass riff. Just great, catchy riff. Really into it. Dig the song. I like the savagery involved in it. And I also like the sophistication going on. Really close attention being paid to production and to development and to composition here. Building in really interesting ways, finding different ways to vary the energy through rhythmic changes, added instrumentation, and through different emphasis in terms of melody, going from, you know, more minor sounds to a more major sound, and then going into these major sevenths and this more colorful sound from the vocal melody. Reflects the series in a certain way. You know, you have this series that is very savage. It's so savage that it almost feels silly, kind of like a Quentin Tarantino film. And you've got these simple desires, you've got this sophistication in the storytelling, and this really interesting viewpoint, this really strange approach. And I feel like that's reflected nicely in this opening music. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope it's given you some perspective on the song and allowed you to enjoy this opening even more so than you did initially. If you did like this, I would love it if you'd subscribe, like, comment, share. Also, check out my music. I just released an emo acoustic album. I think if you like this type of stuff, you'll really like what I've got. And that's right here. That's it. Catch on the flip.
Can you hear the heartbeat? Can you hear the heartbeat? There's no escaping the...